not be familiar with this old Disney classic from 1970. In this story, a family of cats is kidnapped by a jealous butler. Don't worry, all turns out just fine. The song you're about to hear is the song the young kittens are singing for their mother, who is determined to give them proper music lessons.
Streets are full of strangers. song we are about to sing is taken from the hugely popular musical Hamilton, which tells the story of founding father Alexander Hamilton. Soon after the Continental Army wins the war, Hamilton's son, Philip, is born, and his political opponent, Aaron Burr, the man who would later fatally shoot Hamilton, has a daughter named Theodosia. In this tender song, the two men tell their children how they will do anything to protect them.
Dear Theodosia, what to say to you? You have my eyes, you have your mother's name. When you came into the world, you cried, and it broke my heart. I'm dedicating every day to you. Domestic life was never quite my style. When you smile, you knock me out, I fall apart, and I thought I was so smart.
You will come of age with our young nation. We'll beat and fight for you. We'll make it right for you.
Composed by Stephen Sondheim, puts a tangled twist on a happily ever after of fairy tales. Sondheim intertwines the stories of Cinderella, Little Red Riding Hood, Jack, as in Jack and the Beanstalk, by following a baker and his wife as they try to lift a curse placed on their family by a witch, of course. In the happily ever after of Jack, a second giant, seeking revenge, descends down a second beanstalk. After all, Jack was responsible for killing her husband and stealing her treasures. This giantess is wreaking havoc on the village, the palace, and the entire kingdom in her search for Jack. Meanwhile, of course, Cinderella has become disillusioned with her unfaithful prince, Little Red Riding Hood's home and family has been destroyed, and the baker has lost his wife. Things are looking quite dire in the woods. Enter the witch, who has captured Jack and is determined to bring him to the giantess. At this point, the baker turns against Jack, and these two, along with Cinderella and Little Red, blame each other for the situation before all four of them turn against the witch for cursing the father in the first place. It's your fault.
This is all my fault. I shouldn't have let her wander off alone. I should have made her stay with me.
Remorse will get you nowhere.
My wife is dead.
Wake up. When you're dead, you're dead. It's time we get this boy to the giant before we're all so much as dead meat.
No!
This is no time to be soft-hearted. He's going to the giant and I'm taking him.
Yes, yes, he's the one to blame. It's because of you there's a giant in our midst and my wife is dead.
But it isn't my fault, I was given those beans. You persuaded me to trade along a cow full of beans. And without those beans, there had been no stone to get up to the giants in the first place.
Wait a minute, magic bean for a cow so old that you had to tell a lie to sell it, which you told. Were they worthless beans? Were they oversold? Oh, and tellers who persuaded you to steal that gold.
See, it's your fault.
No.
So it's your fault.
No.
Yes, it is.
It's not.
It's true.
Wait a minute, the way you stole the gold to get my cow back from you.
So it's your fault.
Yes.
No, it doesn't. I'd have kept those beans. But her house was cursed. She made us get a cow to get the curse reversed.
It's his father's fault that the curse got placed, and the place got cursed in the first place.
Oh, then it's his fault.
No.
It was his fault.
No.
Yes, it is. It's his.
I guess.
Wait a minute. The witch jumped in the beanstalk bread that's cleared without any beanstalk. Then what's clear is how did the second giant get down here in the first place?
Second place?
Yes.
How?
Well,
who had the other bean?
The other bean.
The other bean?
Who did the other bean?
I didn't. Yes, I did.
So it's your fault.
No, it isn't. I gave it to my wife.
So it's your fault.
No, it isn't.
Then it isn't.
Wait a minute. She exchanged that bean to obtain your shoes, so the one who knows what happened to the bean is you.
You mean that old bean that your wife... Oh, dear, but I never knew it, so I threw... Well, don't look here.
So it's your fault.
But it's your fault.
What?
And is it my nano?
But what?
Well, if you hadn't gone back up again...
We were needy.
You were greedy. Did you need that hen?
But I got it from my mother.
So it's your fault, then.
Yes, and what about the harp in the third place?
The harp, yes.
She went to Dermot, too.
I dared you to.
You did it too. I was scared to death.
No, I didn't.
So it's your fault.
Wait a minute.
If you hadn't teared him too.
And you had left the harp alone, it wouldn't be in trouble in the first
place. She had
it in the first place.
Right, if she's risen beans in the first place.
It's your fault.
You're responsible. You're the one to blame. It's your fault.
Is taken from the Broadway musical, The Wiz, which is an adaptation of L. Frank Baum's novel, The Wizard of Oz. Premiering on Broadway in 1975, this all-black musical was extravaganza, won 7 Tony Awards, including Best Musical, and it ran for 4 years. It was also made into a movie featuring Diana Ross as Dorothy and Michael Jackson as the Scarecrow. The song, Ease On Down the Road, stands as the most remembered song of this production, mostly because it is sung frequently by Dorothy, the Scarecrow, the Cowardly Lion, and the Tin Man as they follow the yellow brick road.
Thank you. Star, which played a minor role in one of the Harry Potter movies, was composed by one of today's finest composers, John Williams. Williams combined lines from parts of the famous scene in Shakespeare's Macbeth when the witches are chanting around the cauldron about something wicked this way turns. John Williams is without a doubt one of the greatest film composers of all time. He has composed music for more than 75 films, which has led to 54 Oscar nominations, including Star Wars, Schindler's List, E.T., Jurassic Park, Superman, Saving Private Ryan, Jaws, Indiana Jones, and more. However, the next song we are going to sing is a John Williams treat. It features the voice, plus Shakespeare, of course.
Broadway productions have captured the imagination and passion of our culture the way Lin-Manuel Miranda's Hamilton has. It took Miranda 7 years to compose this musical that uses rap, hip-hop, soul, and traditional style show tunes. It tells the story of Alexander Hamilton during the American Revolution and some of the political history of the early United States. The song, My Shot, reimagines what Hamilton may have said to his new classmates at King's College in 1776, as he passionately expresses his determination to succeed.
I gotta holler just to be heard. With every word I drop knowledge,
I'm a diamond in the rough. I sign a piece of gold. I reach my goal, my power, my speech is unimpeachable.
The plan is to fan this spark into a flame, but manage to interrupt when you spell out the name.
I am the A-L-E-X-A-N-D-E-R. We are meant to be a colony that runs independently, so there will be a revolution in this century.
Like my country, I'm young, scrappy, and hungry, and I'm not throwing away my
We don't talk about Bruno, no, no, no. We don't talk about Bruno.
I can always hear him sort of muttering and mumbling. I associate him with the sound of falling. Said,
shh, shh, shh. It's a heavy lift with a gift so humbling. Always up to Bella and the family fumbling, grappling with prophecies they couldn't understand. Do you understand a 7-foot frame? Rats along his back. When he calls your name, it all fades to black. Yeah, he sees your dreams and feasts on your screams. We don't talk about Bruno, no, no, no. We don't talk about Bruno.
He told me that fish would die the next day, dead.
No, no.
He told me I grow a gut, and just like he said, no,
he said,
no.
My hair would disappear, now look at my head.
No, no. Your fate is sealed when your prophecy is read. Of my dreams would be promised and someday be mine. He told me that my power would grow like the grapes that thrive on the vine.
Mariano's on his way.
He told me that the man of my dreams would be just out of reach, betrothed to another. It's like I hear.
Truth and the whole truth, Bruno.
So Bella, your boyfriend's here. Time for dinner.
7-foot
ring.
Rats along his back. When he calls your name, it all clouds aloud in the sky. See the
world sitting at the fist
of his
friends. You have the heart on your mind.
7-foot ring. Rats, why did he tell us?
If you love video games, you may recognize this next song from the game Civilization 4. Christopher Tin, the composer, actually won a Grammy for it. And even though it was written for a secular video game, it is actually the Lord's Prayer, word for word in Swahili. The song has touched hundreds of thousands of lives. It is amazing that a song written for a very secular audience is lifting up a prayer to our sovereign God and King, who will bring glory to his name even through a video game. Thank you.
yetu yetu liye minguni yetu yetu amina baba yetu yetu liye njina la kueli tukuzwe
baba yetu yetu liye minguni yetu yetu amina baba yetu yetu liye njina la kueli tukuzwe.
Ma cosa che tu sei? Ma cosa che tu sei? Si tutti cattivi, ma giù i bulacchini.
Yeah. an absurd little bird is popping out to say cuckoo.
Cuckoo.
Regretfully they tell us